from Deputy Mary Lou MacDonald. Please, Deputy Mary Lou MacDonald, you've 2 minutes to it. Please, please, order, please. Could we have some order? I've called Deputy Mary Lou MacDonald.
Gramaga to last Cairn Corlach.
Please, Deputy. Please.
Well, Tornish, though, you failed to answer the first question, so let's see how I get on.
Please.
Tornish, the last night's announcement by the Minister for Finance on the promissory note during a Sinn Féin private members' debate on the ESM blackmail clause begs more questions than it answers.
Please.
Now, as you know, Sinn Féin has been raising this issue for more than a year and calling for a write-down of this odious debt.
Please,
if a deal is agreed today with the ECB, which results in a write-down of that debt, we in Sinn Féin will be the first to welcome it. But before any of us...
Please, deputies, please.
But before any of us pass judgment on the deal, there are a number of questions that must be asked. Will this deal reduce the state's liabilities to Anglo-Irish Bank? Will the debt heaped on the shoulders of the citizens by Fianna Fáil in 2010 and honoured by your government to the tune of $3.1 billion last year be reduced? Will the deal announced by Minister Noonan last night have any effect on the state's debt-to-GDP ratio and, in turn, any impact on our return to the bond markets next year? Will the deal have any impact on this year's deficit or, indeed, the government's plans to suck $3.8 billion from the economy in 2012?
And no point of order, Leader Smith.
$2.25 billion from the economy in 2013.
Thank you, Deputy
McDonald.
Your time is now up. Can I also say
sorry, that's Concorda.
Sorry, your time is almost
up. No, excuse me.
Oh, no.
I have been consistently barracked
my
right.
Please finish your question.
I wish to conclude
remarks. A question, please. Please conclude.
So the question is whether or not any deal agreed in Frankfurt will fundamentally alter the nature of this debt, changing it from a toxic banking debt to a sovereign bond and sovereign debt and all the consequences that that brings. So the question today, Tánaiste, is whether the government has actually secured a deal that reduces the debt, that represents a write-down of that debt to Anglo-Irish Bank, and if in so doing it reduces our deficit and it reduces the extent of cutbacks and hardship experienced by millions of people across the
state. Thank you, Deputy Tánaiste.
Well, first of all, just to correct Deputy MacDonald, this debt did not arise just in 2010. It arose in 2008 when your party, Deputy MacDonald, voted for the bank bailout. That's why. That is why.
Please. Come on, let's.
That is why.
Order, please.
That is why we're in the fix. That's why we're in the fix that we're in, and why this government is now trying to fix that. The current government was landed with the very expensive method of financing Anglo-Irish Bank and Irish Nationwide via promissory notes by the disastrous banking policies of the previous government. Since taking office, yes, and we have, yes, we have, yes, yes. We since taking office, this government has been working hard to lessen to the taxpayer the cost of rescuing the banks. It has involved the long process of building up trust and confidence with our partners in Europe. The government always committed that we would inform the Dáil about any significant development concerning the payment of the promissory note at the end of this month. The Minister for Finance brought the Dáil up to date on that issue last night. In recent months, the government has been involved in technical discussions on reducing the burden of debt associated with the recapitalisation of the banks. In particular, our focus has been on the promissory note arrangement that was put in place to fund the Irish Bank Resolution Corporation, formerly Anglo-Irish Bank and Irish Nationwide. This is an arrangement which requires the state to make cash payments of £3.06 billion each year to IBRC. There have been some developments on this issue in recent days. The discussions with the European authorities on the general issue continue, but we are now negotiating with to IBRC. Some developments on this issue in recent days. The discussions with the European authorities on the general issue continue, but we are now negotiating with to IBRC. Some developments on this issue in recent days. The discussions with the long-term Irish government bond. The details of the arrangement have still to be worked out, but I must reiterate the Minister's statement last night that set out that discussions are ongoing. However, the obvious use of a government bond would have a positive cash flow benefit for the state, as it will free up £3.06 billion of cash that was required to pay the promissory
notes. Thank you, Tánaiste. A supplementary question, Deputy. One minute.
Thank you, Lascar and Corla. Well, it seems from your response, Tánaiste, that uniquely you have been consistent on this matter. The Taoiseach repeatedly told this House that you would not seek a write-down of debt, and you've been true. You've been as good as your word. I find that very disappointing, but not all that surprising. So can you clarify for us at least this? Does the state now have 3.1 or 3.6 billion additional resources to ease the burden on citizens and to row back on your cutbacks and some of your tax hikes? Can you answer that question for the people? And furthermore, Tánaiste, can I say that in your presentation of this matter, can you move from spin and rhetoric and actually be straight with people? What you've done, rather than resolve the debt issue, what you have done is kicked the can further down the road.
Thank you, Deputy.
And the debt will be left intact for future generations and for future governments to meet.
Thank you, Deputy.
You've said that we'll have an
Deputy
additional
McDonald.
£3 billion. Where will you invest that £3 billion? Which of the cutbacks will you row back on? What relief will the citizens
Deputy, thank
have
you very much.
From this deal?
Tánaiste.
Yes, you're right, Deputy MacDonald. I have been consistent on this issue, and the Taoiseach has been consistent on this issue, and the government has been consistent on this issue. We have said, since the time the government was formed, that we would proceed to renegotiate the terms of the bailout arrangements, which we believe are too onerous on the Irish taxpayer. We've been consistent in that, and the Minister for Finance brought the House up to date on the progress that has been made on that to now. You have also been consistent, Deputy MacDonald. You've been consistently wrong. You were wrong, first of all, when you assumed that we wouldn't succeed in negotiating a change in those arrangements. You were wrong when you assumed that we wouldn't secure a reduction in the interest rate. And you were wrong, as I recall it, when you assumed that we wouldn't secure agreement to, for example, reverse the change in the minimum wage. Your problem, Deputy MacDonald, is that you're just... Your problem, Deputy MacDonald, is that you are disappointed that this government is succeeding. And it would do. We are succeeding. And if we succeed, and I repeat the point, if we succeed, and I reiterate that these discussions are not yet concluded, if we succeed in getting an agreement for the replacement of the promissory note by a long-term government bond, that will have enormous benefit to the Irish taxpayer, to this country, and will give this country a great deal of space.
Thank you, Tánaiste. Please. Thank you. Please. Can we have some order, please? Deputy. Sorry, Tánaiste, to conclude.
Deputy Doherty. For a man who got it so outrageously wrong in September 2008, a period of repentant silence would be due from you, the Irish taxpayer.
I'll call next order, Deputy Joe Higgins. Sorry, could we have order, please? Could we have order, please, for the member speaking? Sorry, deputies.